What do you think, which is more important, to understand who Brahman is or to get control over our feelings such as lust, jealousy, anger, hatred and others? Which of the two is more important?
Okay, I just, what the John Carcass question is, we'll try and handle it. He loves to pass these philosophy questions.
I've got it on the...
Okay, now what is more important? Focusing on Brahman or just demolishing this, what we consider to be sinful aspects of our being? Look, I did say this in one of the previous talks. It's very important for us to recognize what we call sin is not that because we are sinners, inherently sinners. We are horrible monsters, cursed monsters. So we have to kind of fight all these sins. Really, if you try and recognize the origin of all the things we call sinful, you'll be very surprised. The origin of all what we call sin, whether it's greed, lust, anger, jealousy, when you really try and analyze how did we acquire this? We are nice human beings. Why? How did these horrible things, become attached to us? Think about it. We have lived many lifetimes, and in many lifetimes we have been buffeted, been beaten up. God knows what has happened to us. It's a frightening scenario. And the history of humanity is so violent and so wild and so horrendous that we have gone through these patches. And there you see this idea of kind of overcoming the enemy, being superior to the other person, and this thing becomes jealousy, fighting for our rights, the survival of the fittest. All these features were inherent in us in the animal kingdom, including lust. God knows for how many lifetimes as animals also you are kind of attracted to the other gender and we're chasing after it. It was a very rewarding experience. So this has all become ingrained in us. So even when we come to the human kingdom, all these things which we have called sinful, their origin is basically the fact that we've gone through so many lifetimes and acquired all this baggage. Once you recognize, look, knowledge is the most powerful tool we possess. Once you recognize, so suppose I feel jealous about somebody. I say, why am I jealous? Maybe in the many previous lives, somebody stronger than me beat me up or something, and that has stayed with me, and I say, I must overcome, I must, beat other people. How can they do better than me? So this jealousy is ingrained because of some horrendous experience I've undergone in my previous life. When you see yourself in that particular, manner, you can overcome what we consider to be sinful or whatever we vilify sin. As our tradition says, we are not sinners. We are the glorious children of immortal bliss, says Swami Vivekananda. So we don't undermine that particular feature. And yet we are covered up with all this filth. And I can use the word filth. So all this filth has been gathered over many lifetimes and it's kind of, it's a crustacean. And we can't see through it. And that is why this idea of Brahman becomes just purely intellectual gymnastics. Mm-hmm. Mr. Lakhani talking about, it sounds nice. So the only thing is, when you remove the crustacean and start recognizing what it is and how you acquired it and rise above it, you can do it. Huh? Look, I'm doing it myself. If I, for example, feel jealousy or anger or something, I ask myself, why? Then I say, I must have undergone some horrendous experience. That's why it's become ingrained in me. So I'm not in that situation anymore. I'm in the human kingdom. I don't need to, show this kind of anger and greed and lust, etc. So I can try and rise. I can try. I'm not saying no guarantee. It is your thinking process, your ability to be knowledgeable about things like this that can allow you to rise above these things. And when you rise about it, what happens? This crustacean that we gather around us, this muck that we have picked up, gets slowly discarded. And when that becomes Brahman, is not something you subscribe. Oh, I want to fall blind Brahman. You are that already. It's just when the crustacean is kind of discarded, you recognize your true nature. And this is an experiential dimension, not intellectual. I like it. I talk about it in my coffee. It is something to experience, and then only you can really don't appreciate it. Until that time, keep challenging me. Keep challenging yourself. This is all waffly stuff, woolly stuff, all the Brahman stuff. What is all that? So keep challenging. That's the right way. Because there's something is there, but I can't get hold of it. And that will prod you to progress further.